Here is a model of amoeba. You know, models are, they have their limited use, but at least here we can see all the structures and we can talk about them. We're on a slide I can't often show you. So we do have the plasma membrane that covers this entire creature, so that's what's green here. And one thing I really do like about the model is that I can see this area underneath the plasma membrane, or the cell membrane, right? That's clear. Okay, so we have the endoplasm and the ectoplasm. Endoplasm is all this area and all the organelles within it, and it's a granular or opaque in appearance. And the ectoplasm is clear and looks kind of gelatinous inside a living creature. Okay, so that's ectoplasm and endoplasm. Now, within the endoplasm, we have all these different circles. Okay, so this circle here, it's got little bits of purple and pink plastic. Might be a little bit hard to see. Well, those are supposed to represent chromosomes. And so you should always be able to at least see the nucleus. On a stained slide, it's always the darkest feature. On living specimens, it can be hard because it's just amongst all this other granular stuff, and it can be really hard to differentiate the different organelles. But on this model, I can point to the nucleus. Now, there are other little plastic pieces floating in clear plastic. And what are these things? Well, a very good question. Perhaps they're food vacuoles. Perhaps this is representing bacteria or other smaller protozoa, maybe a diatom. We really don't know. And so you wouldn't have to know that, but you do have to understand that the organism, the amoeba, eats by endocytosis, and that food is brought in and it's held in a little packet where digestive enzymes are going to be added to it, and then the products are going to be absorbed back to the animal. And then the waste, whatever that is, maybe this is waste, I don't know, that's going to leave the animal by exocytosis, and that can happen anywhere along the plasma membrane. Two other structures we need to look at. One is we have a big clear ball, right? And I assume that this is supposed to represent water. Okay, so water, if this is a freshwater animal, it's going to gain water because the animal is saltier than its environment. And so water, by osmosis, comes into the animal. And the animal has to dump that extra fluid. And this, it does so by putting water into a membrane. And then it releases it to the side, exocytosis. And so that's a contractile vacuole of one kind or another. And it's only really seen in living specimens or on a model. It's so hard to see it on a slide. Another thing that I like about the model is I can actually grab a pseudopod, and so that this structure kind of comes out. This whole thing is a pseudopod, a fake foot, and sometimes I can point to it, but that gets a little tricky. Are you pointing to the membrane? No, I'm talking to this whole thing. So on a diagram, it's very easy. On a model, it's very easy. All right, that's it. I hope you liked the amoeba.